This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Southern Poverty Law Center SPLC is an American nonprofit legal advocacy organization specializing in civil rights and public interest litigation. It is noted for its legal victories against white supremacist groups, its classification of hate groups and other extremist organizations, its legal representation for victims of hate groups, and its educational programs that promote tolerance. The SPLC's classification and listing of hate groups, organizations that in its opinion attack or malign an entire class of people, typically for their immutable characteristics, has been the source of some controversy. In 1971, Morris Dees and Joseph J. Levin Jr. founded the SPLC as a civil rights law firm based in Montgomery, Alabama. Civil rights leader Julian Bond joined Dees and Levin and served as president of the board between 1971 and 1979. The SPLC originally advocated for a broad range of progressive civil rights issues. In 1979, it began to fight the Ku Klux Klan and other white supremacist groups with an innovative litigating strategy involving filing civil suits for monetary damages on behalf of the victims of hate group harassment, threats, and violence. Given the decline in such groups over the years, the SPLC has become involved in other civil rights causes, including cases concerned with institutional racial segregation and discrimination, discrimination based on sexual orientation, the mistreatment of illegal immigrants, and the separation of church and state. Along with civil rights organizations such as the Anti-Defamation League and the Mexican-American Legal Defense and Educational Fund, the SPLC has provided information about hate groups to the Federal Bureau of Investigation FBI. The SPLC has been criticized for its fundraising tactics and some listings of individuals and groups. The SPLC does not accept government funds, nor does it charge its clients legal fees or share in their court-awarded judgments. Most of its funds come from direct mail campaigns, which have helped it to build substantial monetary reserves. Contents 1. History 2. Notable victories 21. YMCA, Montgomery, Alabama 22. Vietnamese Fishermen 23. White Patriot Party 24. United Clans of America 25. White Aryan Resistance 26. Church of the Creator 27. Christian Knights of the KKK 28. Aryan Nations 29. Ten Commandments Monument 210. Ranch Rescue 211. Billy Ray Johnson 212. Imperial Clans of America 213. Walnut Grove Youth Correctional Facility 3. Education 31. Tolerance Org 32. Documentaries 33. Law Enforcement Training 4. Tracking of Hate Groups and Extremists 41. Hate Group Listings 42. Intelligence Report 43. Year in Hate and Extremism 44. Academic Assessment 45. Controversy over Hate Group and Extremist Listings 5. Finances 6. See also 7. Notes 8. References 9. External links. History. The SPLC headquarters in Montgomery, Alabama. The Southern Poverty Law Center was founded by civil rights lawyers Morris Dees and Joseph J. Levin, Jr. in 1971 as a law firm originally focused on issues such as fighting poverty, discrimination and the death penalty in the United States. The SPLC's first president was Julian Bond, who served as president until 1979 and remained on its board of directors until his death on August 15, 2015. In 1979, Dees decided to begin monitoring far-right groups such as the Ku Klux Klan, sharing their observations with law enforcement agencies which, after the COINTELPRO program was revealed, were forbidden from monitoring such groups without evidence of criminal activity and suing them for monetary damages on behalf of their victims. In 1981, the center began its KlanWatch project to monitor the activities of the KKK. That project, now called HateWatch, has been expanded to include 7 other types of hate organizations. In July 1983, the center's office was firebombed, destroying the building and records. In February 1985, Klan members and a Klan sympathizer pleaded guilty to federal and state charges related to the fire at the trial. Klansmen Joe M. Garner and Roy T. Downs Jr., along with Charles Bailey, pleaded guilty to conspiring to intimidate, oppress, and threaten members of Black organizations represented by SPLC. According to Dees, more than 30 people have been jailed in connection with plots to kill him or blow up the center. In 1984, Dees became an assassination target of the Order, a revolutionary white supremacist group. Another target, radio host Alan Berg, was murdered outside his Colorado home in 1986. The entire legal staff of the SPLC, excluding Dees, resigned as the organization reoriented itself away from traditional civil rights work towards fighting rights right-wing extremism in 1987, SPLC won a case against the United Klans of America for the lynching of Michael Donald, a black teenager in Mobile, Alabama. The SPLC used an unprecedented legal strategy of holding an organization responsible for the crimes of individual members to help produce a $7. Death of an Ethiopian immigrant while Metzger lost his home and ability to publish material. Only a small fraction of the multi-million dollar damages were recoverable. The center's Teaching Tolerance project was initiated in 1991, and its KlanWatch program has gradually expanded to include other anti-hate monitoring projects and a list of reported hate groups in the United States. In 1995, four white men were indicted for planning to blow up the SPLC. In 1994, the Montgomery Advertiser published an 8-part critical report on the SPLC, saying that it exaggerated the threat posed by the Klan and similar groups to raise money, discriminated against black employees, and used misleading fundraising tactics. The SPLC dismissed the series as a hatchet job. In May 1998, three white supremacists were arrested for allegedly planning a nationwide campaign of assassinations and bombings targeting Morris Dees, an undisclosed federal judge in Illinois, a black radio show host in Missouri, Dees's Southern Poverty Law Center in Alabama, the Simon Wiesenthal Center in Los Angeles, and the Anti-Defamation League in New York. In 1999, the SPLC broke ground on their new headquarters building. It was completed in 2001. The SPLC has been criticized for using hyperbole and overstating the prevalence of hate groups to raise large amounts of money. In a 2000 Harper's Magazine article, Ken Silverstein said that Dees has kept the SPLC focused on fighting anti-minority groups like the KKK, whose membership has declined to just 2,000, instead of on issues like homelessness, mostly because the former issue makes for more lucrative fundraising. The article claimed the SPLC spends twice as much on fundraising, $576 million last year, as it does on legal services for victims of civil rights abuses. Harper's pointed out that more than 95% of hate crimes are committed by lone wolves without any connection to militia groups. The SPLC speaks of in July 2007, the SPLC filed suit against the Imperial Klans of America, IKA, in Meade County, where in July 2006 five Klansmen allegedly beat Jordan Groover, a 16-year-old boy of Panamanian descent, at a Kentucky county fair. After filing the suit, the SPLC received nearly a dozen threats during the November 2008 civil trial. A former member of the IKA said that the Klan head told him to kill Dees in 2008. The SPLC and Dees were featured on National Geographic's Inside American Terror, exploring their litigation against several branches of the Ku Klux Klan. Notable victories: the Southern Poverty Law Center has won multiple civil cases resulting in monetary awards for the plaintiffs. The SPLC has said it does not accept any portion of monetary judgments. Dees and the SPLC have been credited with devising innovative legal ways to cripple hate groups, including seizing their assets. However, this has led to criticism from some civil libertarians, who contend that the SPLC's tactics chill free speech and set legal precedents that could be applied against activist groups which are not hate groups. The SPLC has also entered suits related to mass incarceration and children's rights in prison and criminal justice issues. YMCA, Montgomery, Alabama. In 1969, prior to founding the SPLC, Dees sued the Young Men's Christian Association, YMCA, in Montgomery, Alabama, at the request of civil rights activist Mary Louise Smith, whose son Vincent and nephew Edward the YMCA had refused to allow to attend its summer camp. The YMCA, being a private organization, was presumptively not bound by the provisions of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which would have forbidden them to discriminate against children on the basis of race. However, Dees discovered that, in order to avoid desegregating its recreational facilities, the city of Montgomery had instead signed a secret agreement with the YMCA to operate them as private facilities, but on the city's behalf. This led the trial court to rule that the YMCA had a municipal charter and was therefore bound by the 14th Amendment to the United States Constitution to desegregate its facilities. According to historian Timothy Minchin, Dees was emboldened by this victory when he founded the SPLC in 1971. The United States Court of Appeals for the Fifth Circuit Alpha later affirmed the trial judge's finding, reversing only his order that the YMCA use affirmative action to racially integrate its board of directors Vietnamese fishermen in 1981, the SPLC took Ku Klux Klan leader Louis Beam's Klan-associated militia, the Texas Emergency Reserve TER, to court to stop racial harassment and intimidation of Vietnamese shrimpers in and around Galveston Bay. The Klan's actions against approximately 100 Vietnamese shrimpers in the area included a cross-burning, sniper fire aimed at them, and arsonists burning their boats in May 1981. U.S. District Court Judge Gabrielle McDonald issued a preliminary injunction against the Klan, requiring them to cease intimidating, threatening, or harassing the Vietnamese. McDonald eventually found the TER and Beam guilty of tortious interference, violations of the Sherman Antitrust Act, and of various civil rights statutes, and thus permanently enjoined them against violence, threatening behavior, and other harassment of the Vietnamese shrimpers. The SPLC also uncovered an obscure Texas law that forbade private armies in that state. McDonald found that Beam's organization violated it and hence ordered the TER to close its military training camp White Patriot Party in 1982. Armed members of the Carolina Knights of the Ku Klux Klan terrorized Bobby Person, a black prison guard, and members of his family. They harassed and threatened others, including a white woman who had befriended blacks in 1984. Person became the lead plaintiff in Person v. Carolina Knights of the Ku Klux Klan, a lawsuit brought by the SPLC in the United States District Court for the Eastern District of North Carolina. The harassment and threats continued during litigation, and the court issued an order prohibiting any person from interfering with others inside the courthouse in January 1985. The court issued a consent order that prohibited the groups Grand Dragon, Frazier Glenn Miller Jr., and his followers from operating a paramilitary organization, holding parades in black neighborhoods, and from harassing, threatening, or harming any black person or white persons who associated with black persons. Subsequently, the court dismissed the plaintiff's claim for damages. Within a year, the court found Miller and his followers, now calling themselves the White Patriot Party, in criminal contempt for violating the consent order. Miller was sentenced to 6 months in prison, followed by a 3-year probationary period, during which he was banned from associating with members of any racist group such as the White Patriot Party. Miller refused to obey the terms of his probation. He made underground declarations of war against Jews and the federal government before being arrested again, found guilty of weapons violations. He went to federal prison for 3 years. United Klans of America. In 1987, the SPLC successfully brought a civil case against the United Klans of America UKA for the 1981 lynching of Michael Donald in Mobile, Alabama by two of the UKA's members. Unable to come up with the $7 judgment against him in 1995, the amount was upheld on appeal and the money was collected prior to Pierce's death in 2002. Christian Knights of the KKK. The SPLC won a $378. Aryan Nations member then held the Kenans at gunpoint as a result of the judgment. Richard Butler turned over the 20-acre 81,000. Sutton. They were accosted by vigilantes known as Ranch Rescue, who were recruited by Sutton to patrol the U.S.-Mexico border region nearby. According to the SPLC, Gonzalez and Medina were held at gunpoint, and Gonzalez was struck on the back of the head with a handgun, and a Rottweiler dog was allowed to attack him. The SPLC said Gonzalez and Medina were threatened with death and otherwise terrorized before being released. However, the Salvadorans stated the ranchers gave them water, cookies, and a blanket before letting them go. After about an hour, Ranch rescuer Casey James Nethercott denied hitting either of the trespassers with a gun, and no one was convicted of pistol whipping. In 2003, SPLC, the Mexican American Legal Defense and Educational Fund, and local attorneys filed a civil suit, Leyva v. Ranch Rescue, in Jim Hogg County, Texas, against Ranch Rescue and several of its associates, seeking damages for assault and illegal detention. In April 2005, SPLC obtained judgments totaling $1 million against Nethercott and Ranch Rescue. Rescue's leader, Torre John Foote. Those awards came 6 months after a $350,000 judgment in the same case and coincided with a $100,000 out-of-court settlement with Sutton. Nethercott's 70-acre 280,000. Billy Ray Johnson. The SPLC brought a civil suit on behalf of Billy Ray Johnson, a black, mentally disabled man, who was severely beaten by four white males and left bleeding in a ditch, suffering permanent injuries. Johnson was awarded $9. In a related criminal case in February 2007, Jared Hensley and Andrew Watkins were sentenced to 3 years in prison for beating Groover on November 14, 2008. An all-white jury of 7 men and 7 women awarded $15 million in compensatory damages and $1 million in punitive damages to the plaintiff against Ron Edwards, Imperial Wizard of the Group, and Jared Hensley, who participated in the attack. The two other defendants, Andrew Watkins and Joshua Cowles, previously agreed to confidential settlements and were dropped from the suit. Walnut Grove Youth Correctional Facility, together with the ACLU National Prison Project, the SPLC, filed a class action suit in November 2010 against the owner-operators of the private Walnut Grove Youth Correctional Facility in Leake County, Mississippi, and oversight state agencies. This was the largest youth facility in the nation. They charged that conditions, including understaffing and neglect of medical care, produced numerous and repeated abuses of youthful prisoners, and high rates of violence and injury. One prisoner suffered permanent brain damage. A federal civil rights investigation was also undertaken by the United States Department of Justice, and the issues received national coverage. Mississippi ended its contract with GEO Group in 2012, which settled the suit. In addition, under the court decree, the Mississippi Department of Corrections has moved youthful offenders from Walnut Grove to other facilities that meet juvenile justice standards. In 2012, it opened a new youthful offender unit at the Central Mississippi Correctional Facility in Rankin County as a landmark element of the settlement. The state is prohibited by the court from subjecting any youthful offenders to solitary confinement under the settlement decree. A court monitor is conducting regular reviews of conditions at Walnut Grove Correctional Facility, now reserved for adult prisoners. Education TolerantSorg. Close-up of the Civil Rights Memorial. The SPLC's initiatives include the website TolerantSorg, past winner of the International Webby Award. The site provides daily news on tolerance issues, educational games for children, guidebooks for activists, and resources for parents and teachers. The site's Teaching Tolerance initiative is aimed at two different age groups of students, with separate materials for teachers and parents. One portion of the project is for elementary school children, providing material on the history of the civil rights movement. The center's material includes a publication entitled A Fresh Look at Multicultural American English, which explores the cultural history of common words. A project website includes an interactive program addressing such topics as Native American school mascots, displays of the Confederate flag, and the themes of popular music and entertainment, encouraging pupils to consider racial, gender, and sexual orientation sensitivities. A similar program aimed at middle and high school pupils includes a Mix It Up project, urging readers to participate in school activities involving interaction between different social groups. Other features of this project includes political activism tips and reports highlighting student activism. The SPLC puts out a monthly publication typically focusing on a minority, feminist, or LGBT youth organization. Publications such as 10 Ways to Fight Hate on Campus suggest ideas for community activism and diversity education. Teaching Tolerance also provides advice to parents, encouraging multiculturalism in the upbringing of their children. A guide urges parents to examine the diversity profile of your children's friends, to move to integrated and economically diverse neighborhoods, and to discourage children from playing with toys or adopting heroes that promote violence. The publication also advises parents to use culturally sensitive language such as the gender-neutral phrasing "someone special day" instead of the traditional Mother's Day and Father's Day, and to make sure that cultural diversity is reflected in your home's artwork, music and literature. Documentaries. The SPLC also produces documentary films. Two have won Academy Awards for documentary short subject: Mighty Times, The Children's March 2005, and A Time for Justice 1995. Another film was Wall of Tolerance, starring Jennifer Welker. Five others have been nominated for awards. Citation Needed. Law enforcement training. The SPLC offers training for local, state and federal law enforcement officers by request, focusing on the history, background, leaders and activities of far-right extremists in the United States. Tracking of hate groups and extremists. Hate group listings. Main article: List of organizations designated by the Southern Poverty Law Center as hate groups. The SPLC maintains a list of hate groups defined as groups that have beliefs or practices that attack or malign an entire class of people, typically for their immutable characteristics. It says that hate group activities may include speeches, marches, rallies, meetings, publishing, leafleting, and criminal acts such as violence. It says not all groups so listed by the SPLC engage in criminal activity. The FBI has partnered with the SPLC and many other local and national organizations to establish rapport, share information, address concerns, and cooperate in solving problems. Number of SPLC hate groups per million people, as of 2013. In 2016, the SPLC reported that 892 hate groups were active in the United States in 2015, an increase of 14% over the 784 active the year before. The top five states based on hate groups per population are Montana, Mississippi, Arkansas, Vermont, and New Hampshire. Intelligence report since 1981. The SPLC's intelligence project has published a quarterly intelligence report that monitors what the SPLC considers radical right hate groups and extremists in the United States. The intelligence report provides information regarding organizational efforts and tactics of these groups, and has been cited by scholars as reliable and as the most comprehensive source on U.S. right-wing extremism and hate groups. The SPLC also publishes Hatewatch Weekly, a newsletter that follows racism and extremism, and the Hatewatch blog, whose subtitle is Keeping an Eye on the Radical Right. Two articles published in Intelligence Report have won Green Eyeshade Excellence in Journalism awards from the Society of Professional Journalists. Communing with the Council, written by Heidi Byrick and Bob Moser, took third place for investigative journalism in the magazine division in 2004, and Southern Gothic, by David Holthaus and Casey Sanchez, took second place for feature reporting in the magazine division in 2007. On March 20, 2009, the Intelligence Project received a Distinguished Public Service Award from the American Immigration Law Foundation for its outstanding work covering the anti-immigration movement year in hate and extremism since 2001. The SPLC has released an annual issue of the Intelligence Project called Year in Hate, later renamed Year in Hate and Extremism, in which they present statistics on the numbers of hate groups in America. The current format of the report covers racial hate groups, nativist hate groups, and other right-wing extremist groups, such as groups within the Patriot Movement. Academic assessment in their study of the white separatist movement in the United States, sociologists Betty A. Dobritz and Stephanie L. Shanks-Mile referred to the SPLC's ClanWatch intelligence reports in saying, "We relied on the SPLC and ADL for general information, but we have noted differences between the way events have been reported and what we saw at rallies. For instance, events were sometimes portrayed in ClanWatch intelligence reports as more militant and dangerous with higher turnouts than we observed." Rory McVeigh, the chair of the University of Notre Dame Sociology Department, wrote that "its outstanding reputation is well established, and the SPLC has been an excellent source of information for social scientists who study racist organizations' controversy over hate group and extremist listings." The SPLC's identifications and listings of hate groups have been the subject of controversy, with critics, including journalist Ken Silverstein and analyst of political fringe movements Laird Wilcox, arguing that the SPLC has taken an incautious approach to assigning the label in the wake of an August 2012 shooting at the headquarters of the Family Research Council in which a guard was wounded. Some columnists criticized the SPLC's listing of the Family Research Council as an anti-gay hate group, while others defended the categorization. The SPLC defended its listing of anti-gay hate groups, stating that groups were selected not because of their stances on political issues such as gay marriage, but rather on their propagation of known falsehoods about LGBT people that have been thoroughly discredited by scientific authorities. In 2010, a group of Republican politicians and conservative organizations criticized the SPLC in full-page advertisements in two Washington, D.C., newspapers for what they described as character assassination for having listed the Family Research Council as a hate group in October 2014. The SPLC added Ben Carson to its extremist watch list, citing his association with groups it considers extreme, and his alleged linking of gays with pedophiles. In February 2015, the SPLC concluded the Carson profile did not meet SPLC standards, removed his listing, and apologized to him in October 2016. The SPLC published a list of anti-Muslim extremists, including British activist Majid Nawaz and ex-Muslim Ayaan Hirsi Ali, attracting controversy. Nawaz, who identifies as a liberal, reform Muslim, denounced the listing as a smear, saying that the SPLC listing had made him a target of jihadists. The SPLC responded, "Our point is not to make these people targets for violence. The point is to tamp down the really baseless targeting." Finances. The SPLC's activities, including litigation, are supported by fundraising efforts, and it does not accept any fees or share in legal judgments awarded to clients it represents in court. Starting in 1974, the SPLC set aside money for its endowment, stating that it was convinced that the day come when non-profit groups no longer be able to rely on support through mail because of posting and printing costs. The SPLC has received criticism for perceived disproportionate endowment reserves and misleading fundraising practices. In 1994, the Montgomery Advertiser ran a series reporting that the SPLC was financially mismanaged and employed misleading fundraising practices in response. SPLC co-founder Joe Levin stated, "The Advertiser's lack of interest in the center's programs and its obsessive interest in the center's financial affairs and Mr. D's personal life makes it obvious to me that the Advertiser simply wants to smear the center and Mr. D's." The series was a finalist for but did not win a 1995 Pulitzer Prize in Explanatory Journalism. In 1996, USA Today called the SPLC the nation's richest civil rights organization, with $68. Foundation Center retrieved April 22, 2014. Carrot Michael, George 2012. Lone Wolf Terror and the Rise of Leaderless Resistance. Vanderbilt University Press p. Retrieved September 18, 2007. Carrot 5 tied to Klan indicted on arms charges. The New York Times January 9, 1987. Retrieved September 18, 2007. Carrot Law Center begins project. Montgomery Advertiser February 16, 1999. 2007. New Millennium Sage Publications p. Fighting Hate in the Courtroom. SPLC Reports Special Issue, Volume 38, No. 4 Winter 2008 p. 4. Supremacist Glenn Miller Gets 5 Years in Prison. Star News January 5, 1988. Retrieved September 10, 2012. Carrot D's. Carrot Joaquin, Daniel J. September 9, 2004. Richard G. Butler, 86, dies, founder of the Aryan Nations. The New York Times retrieved August 22, 2007. Carrot $9 million award in beating case. Chicago Tribune, April 21, 2007. Retrieved December 10, 2010. Carrot Parker, Laura, April 26, 2007. A jury stand against racism reflects hope. USA Today retrieved August 17, 2007. Carrot MDOC opens youthful offender unit. Press release, the 12th of December 2012. Mississippi Department of Corrections accessed the 30th of January 2016. Carrot CB et al. V. Walnut Grove Correctional Authority et al. Southern Poverty Law Center. Carrot AB Tolerance.org about us. Southern Poverty Law Center 2005. Retrieved August 17, 2007. www.tolerance.org retrieved October 13, 2015. Relations has more than doubled in the past 2 years. Atlanta Blackstar retrieved 20 April 2016. Southern Poverty Law Center archived from the original on August 21, 2007. Retrieved September 18, 2007.